Assalamu alaikum. Peace and blessings be upon you all. A very good morning, dear children. I'm Asim Ansari, your maths teacher. Today, we are going to learn the last part of our more division lesson. Dear children, in this Unit 6 more division video lesson, we will be learning how to solve division word problems. Dear children, let's know when do we actually divide, under which condition we actually divide. So the first condition is when we know total number and also the number of groups. Total number is given to us and the number of groups is given to us. We use division to find how many in each group. Let's see the next condition. When we know the total number and also the number in each group, we use division to find how many groups. So let's see the next condition. When we know the value for many and need to find the value of one, we use division. So let's see the last condition. When we subtract the same number repeatedly, we use division. Dear children, now let's study each one of this condition with an example. Now let's see the first question. 24 students took part in a relay race on school sports day. If there were 6 teams in the race, how many students were there in each team? So let's study this example more clearly. So what is given to us? 24 students are there. Total number of students taking part in school race is 24. That is given to us. Number of teams is 6. And what we need to find? Number of students in each team. So here, when we know the total number and also the number of groups, to find how many in each group, what do? We use division. So we need to divide here. So 24 is to be divided by 6. We can do it in the short way. As this number is easy, we know in 6 table when 24. We can go ahead and do it in the short way also. But we can also use the long division method and find out the answer. So 24 is to be divided by 6. So 2 is very small, so 0 times, and then we will take 24 all together. So 6 fours are 24. So we subtract, then there is nothing remaining, so 0. So how many students in each team? There are 4 students in each team. Easy, is it, children? This is the first condition, when we know the total number and also the number of groups. To find how many in each group, we use division. Let's see this next example. 12 students participated in a quiz. There were 4 students in each team. How many teams were there? So, my children, let's study this in detail. First, what is given? Total number of students participated in the quiz, we know. It's 12. Number of students in each team, we know, that's 4. Now we need to know the number of teams. So what is given to us here? Total number is given. The number in each group is given. And to find how many groups, what do we need to do? We need to divide. So 12 has to be divided by 4. This is an easy one. In 4 table when 12, we know it 3 times. So the answer is 3. So we'll end this with a statement. There were 3 teams participating in the quiz. Done. Let's study this third question. Adil bought 9 books for rupees 45. If each book cost the same, how much does one book cost? So let's study this question in detail. Total amount of money is rupees 45. Total amount is given. Number of books bought is 9. Cost of one book we need to know. So, given for many, finding for one or each. So what do? We divide. This is the third condition given. So we have to divide 45 rupees with 9. So what we will get? It's quite easy. In 9 table, when 45, it's 5 times, so 5. So we let us end it up with a statement. One book cost rupees 5. Let's see this question. How many times can you take away 7 from 42? So let's study this question in detail. Number given is 42. Number to be taken away each time is 7. Number of times we will be taking away the 7, we don't know. So let's see this number is given to us. Yes. Now same number is to be taken away each time. So that is the condition of subtracting the same number repeatedly. So it is when we subtract the same number repeatedly, we divide. So we need to divide this 42 with 7. And this is an easy one. In 7 table, we know when 42, it's 6 times. So we need to end it with a statement. We can take away 7 from 42 6 times. So this was the last condition given. Where we subtract the same number repeatedly. Let's see another question. 35 tires were being put on cars. If each car needs 4 tires, how many cars can be fitted with tires? How many tires will not be used? So let's study this question in detail. Total number of tires, 35 tires is given to us. Each car needs 4 tires, that is also given. So number of cars fitted with tires, we don't know. Number of tires left out, we don't know. So let's see the condition here. When we know the total number, yes, total number is given to us. And also the number in each group, yes, number in each group is 4, we also know that. So to find how many groups, so that we will be doing through division, right? So we need to divide this one. So 35 is to be divided by 4. So let's go for long division method. So 3 is smaller than 4, so 0 times. So let's take 35 altogether and check out in 4 table when 35. 4 sevens are 28, 4 eights are 32, 4 nines are 36. 36 is becoming too big, so we have to go for 4 eights are 32. So we will subtract. Now 3 remains. So that means 8 cars can be fitted with tires and 3 tires will be left out. The quotient will become the answer, that is the number of cars fitted with tires. That will be 8 cars will be fitted with tires and the remainder will be the leftover, that is the number of tires which were left, 3 tires which were left. When we solve what problems, most of the children find it difficult to decide when to divide or to multiply. Let's see this comparison between multiplication and division word problems, which will help us in deciding the operation correctly. So let's see the first point. Groups of parts are of the same size in multiplication word problems as well as in division word problems. That's the first point. So let's see the second point. You are asked to find the total in multiplication word problems, and in division word problems you already know the total. That's the main difference. Here in multiplication you are asked to find the total, in division you already know the total. Let's see the third point. You know how many groups or parts or the size of each group or part in multiplication, but in division you are asked to find how many groups or parts are there, or what is the size of each group or part in division. So the main difference between multiplication and division word problems can be stated as this. Given for one, finding for many is multiplication, and given for many, finding for one or each is division. If you remember this much, my children, you will be able to solve the multiplication and division problems very easily. You can understand the difference between the multiplication and division problem very easily. So what is the main point to remember? In multiplication, you are finding for many. In division, you are finding for one or each. Okay, my children, is it clear? Dear children, let's practice some more questions. And here you have to decide whether to multiply or to divide. Let's see this question. Seven dwarfs had 86 apples and they shared them equally. How many apples did each one get is the question. So let's study the question in detail. What is given here? The total number of apples is 86. So number of dwarfs are 7. So number of apples each will get, that is the question which we need to answer. So here what is given? Given for many. We are finding for one or each. So what do? We divide. That's easy, isn't it? We have decided the operation. So let's divide. 86 is to be divided by 7. Let's put it in the log division form. The higher place digit is to be divided. It will be 7 ones are 7. So let's subtract. We get a 1. Then we need to drop the next number, that's 6. So 7 twos are 14, 7 threes are 21. 21 becomes too big. So we have to go for 7 twos are 14. So let's subtract. Now what remains? 2 remains. So we need to answer the question here. How many apples did each one get? So what will be the answer? Each dwarf will get 12 apples. So 2 apples are remaining, but it's in the question it did not ask how many apples are left over. So we will just leave it out. Whatever is asked, that much only we will answer. Dear children, let's see this question and decide the operation correctly. So what's the question? Shirin bought 5 baskets with 6 mangoes in each basket. How many mangoes did Shirin buy? So let's study this question in detail. What's given here? One basket has 6 mangoes. So in 5 baskets, how many mangoes we have to know? So what's the condition here? Given for one, finding for many. So multiplication. Isn't it, my children? So here we will multiply. So 5, 6 are 30. Now we will end it with a statement. Shirin bought 30 mangoes. Was it easy, my children? Let's try to solve this question and decide the operation correctly, my dear children. So what's given? Shaggy and Scooby made 32 pancakes. They split them equally. How many pancakes would they each get to eat? Let's study this question in detail. What do we have? Total number of pancakes, 32. The number of people, 2. How did I take it as 2? Because there are 2 names, Shaggy and Scooby. 1 plus 1, 2. That's how. Number of pancakes each will get to eat, we don't know. So what is the condition here? Given for many, finding for one or each. So we divide. Isn't it easy, my children? Let's divide. 32 to be divided by 2. So we'll put it in log division form. The highest digit is to be divided. 3 is to be divided by 2. It 2 table went 3. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. 4 becomes too big. So we'll go for 2 ones are 2. And then we subtract. So what remains? 1 remains. So then the next number is to be brought down. So 2 is to be brought down. The new number becomes 12. So 12 is to be divided by 2. So it will be 6 times. 2, 6 are 12. So we subtract. Nothing remains. So let us answer the question. The statement will become, each will get to eat 16 pancakes. Let's practice this question and decide the operation, my children. Tweedledum and Tweedledee had bought 75 roses for the Queen of Hearts. She had 5 vases and they decided to put equal amount of roses in each vase so that it looked just perfect. How many roses would they put in each vase? So let's study this question in detail. So total number of roses is 75. So did you see, children? Total number is given. Number of vases, 5. So what is to be done? Given for many, finding for one. So divide, right? So what is to be done? We have to divide. 75 is to be divided by 5. Let's put it in the log division form. So 5 table with 7, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 twos are 10 will become 2 weeks. So one time we have to take. So 5 ones are 5. Now we subtract 2 remains. We bring down the next number. The new number becomes 25. Oh, it's so easy. 5 table with 25, it's 5 times. So 5 fives are 25. So the thing remains. So what is the answer now? They will put 15 roses in each vase. Right, children? Easy?